This is our Tuesday night ride, group ride.
Yeah, same here.
There are three groups usually that go, C group, 15 to 18 miles an hour, I think, and then the B group, 18 to 20, and A group, 20 to 22. This is the U group, U for upper, and usually speeds are 24 miles an hour or above. And here we are, we're just starting out our group ride, middle of September. It's pretty warm that day, 95 degrees, and I'm just getting headed out of the parking lot and getting started on the group ride. I'm on my Machetta Carbonero 2.0 bike, and been riding with this group for a few years now, and haven't had any problems riding with the upright riders. It's usually I get along pretty good. And we're just headed out and headed down this little hill. Typically hang out in the back of the group, trying to be conscious of the fact that I'm not generating any draft, and plus it's a little bit easier just to control the bike back here. The acceleration's a little different than an upright bike, and tends to carry more speed in to the bottom of a hill and going downhill than an upright rider would typically. Some of the local guys from the local racing club there. So I have this bike set up with 28 millimeter tubeless wheels. Feels really good and tracks really well. Grips the road really well and handles corners really well. A lot of confidence there. Plus it helps absorb all the road vibration that you would normally feel when you're coming, because you can't unload the bike like you can an upright bike. And I also have the steering set up for a tiller steer, just mainly because I can get better visibility over the front of the bike. And also it allows you to keep turning or keep pedaling while you're turning, which I always had a hard time with the U-bars. Those, if you had to turn sharply after starting, you had to kind of coast. And it was always difficult to catch up to the group after that. So here we are headed back out now. And so this guy here, I gave him plenty of room to get up front. I usually don't try to block people out. If they need to catch the draft, I usually try to be mindful that they can use the draft better than I can. So I'm just kind of hang out in the back. I don't usually ride in the middle of the group or in front. It's a lot more work to ride in the middle, just because the power curve is a little different on the incumbent. And a lot of times when I ride, if I make it to the front of the group, I find that there's no one behind me. They've all moved over to the other lane. It's just because, you know, the speed's above 24 miles an hour. It's just that draft is really helpful. I think for slower groups, it's probably not that much of a problem. So we're headed out to the first segment of the ride, the Big House Loop. We'll be starting it here, just kind of a warm-up. Taking a right here in a minute, starting the segment. The Big House Loop is a pretty popular segment here, locally. Here's the right turn. A little bit of a rise here, about 3%. I see guys getting up off their saddle. And you have to power through this a little bit. And it was always kind of a struggle just to keep up on the recumbent in this. But today it wasn't too bad. A little crest on top of this hill, and there's a long downhill and carry a lot of speed down through. And this is the beginning of the Big House Loop. a lot of holes in this part of the ride. Guys calling them out and doing a good job. Some of those holes are pretty big. So we'll get to the bottom of this hill and be carrying a little bit of speed, probably about 25 miles an hour through the right turn that we're coming up and another hill after that. Getting back on the power. Gotta start hammering pretty good. And one thing that I found on riding with uprights is coming up to, let's say we're riding on a flat here, we're going to come up to the bottom of the hill. A lot of times I got to brake momentarily at the bottom of the hill. I think the rear comet tends to carry a little bit more speed on the flats. And I generally like to carry some momentum going up a hill just so I can keep my cadence up. And it's a little more difficult being behind somebody having to shift down and brake your cadence. And having the power and tractor through that hill. Here we are on the downhill now. These long downhills are usually have to tap and drag the brakes a little bit just to kind of keep the position. So the camera is mounted about the same level my eyes would be, so you're kind of seeing pretty much what I get to see when I'm riding in a group. Can't see a whole lot beyond the guy in front of me. There's big house loop, keep going here, and usually get on the power pretty good in this segment. There's a hill coming up, and you had to tap the brakes here just a little bit. Here comes a little bit of a hill, and it used to be I would drop back a little bit on this hill, but this year I was able to keep up. Either that or they're slowed down a little bit. That's 3%, and we're keeping a pretty good pace coming up. You see the guy in front pedaling pretty good there. Come up on a long downhill segment and into a right turn. A little bit of traffic that night, usually not that much traffic on this ride. It's coasting along at 30. Ready for the right turn. Usually you can carry some pretty good speed here. I think we got a little bit crowded. No, not too bad. Now you're back on the power pretty good. Usually here lately, this is where people like to hammer a little bit during this little section of road in the big house loop. We're coming up in an intersection. And there's a stop sign, but moving along like this a lot of times, not so much fun to stop. And back on the power. Still hanging out in the back. This is one of my favorite parts here, this little S-turn's a lot of fun. I've noticed on this turn that I'm able to keep pedaling, whereas an upright batter biker would have to coast through because of the amount of lean in the turn. But since the pedals are high up off the ground, I can keep pedaling, keep the power on, and usually gain a little bit. But I got crowded there a little bit. That time was no need to be aggressive on a group ride. You're just having a good time. And this segment here is called the Safe Sprint, and usually carry quite a bit of speed through here, but it got a little crowded this night. And the oncoming traffic, we had to bunch up and tap on the brakes, and just wasn't able to go as fast as we usually do. Which is fine. And that's the end of the big house. It's a little bit of a cool down, and on to the next part. There's two hills coming up here. These hills I usually struggle with. I try not to max out my heart rate too much, so I'm just going to spin up them and not work too hard. There's a long downhill segment after, so I don't mind dropping to the back of the pack here. I didn't need to be up that high anyway. So letting these guys pass, I'm just going to keep some moderate spin on. I don't want to max out my heart rate too much. This hill does seem like it goes on for quite a while, but the long hill afterward is pretty nice. Now we just get to coast for a little while. Yeah. Just tuck in, get aerodynamic, and just take a little rest. I see guys getting tucked in behind each other. Just coasting down the hill at 34. That's pretty nice. Get behind this guy, get a little draft, a little increase in speed. Just coast around him. Come to the intersection, slow down, get on the main road. Back on the power, get caught back up. So still hanging out in the back of the group. It's nice and flat here. And the group did get a little yo-yo action going on in the back here. Speeding up and slowing down, you can see. Back on the power and then the back off. A lot of times when I'm in a group, I'll hang out a little bit and get a little breeze. It's not always fun being behind a guy catching a draft. You want to be catching a little wind. And this segment here is pretty flat. And a lot of times I'll just keep pedaling, keep the power on, and jump up to the front of the group. Typically in this segment, that's what I usually do. Just keep the power on and let the speed roll up a little bit. Keep the power on until we get to the Wolf River. Very nice and flat here, nice and smooth. This guy ever saw me. I don't think he did. So I've got mirrors set up on my bar so I can see back pretty well. I'm taking a left turn up here, so I gotta get over. Get back off the power, coming up to the stop sign. Plus I'm getting tired at this point too. Shift into the small ring because it's kind of hard to start on the big ring. But that's just a little insight on some of the challenges and fun stuff you can find while riding recumbent in a group ride.